So my wife comes home with a spray tan the other day and is waiting, expecting for me to compliment her. But I'm just thinking, why would I compliment a spray tan? It looked fine. It looked nice. But a spray tan does not seem something compliment worthy. Luce, do you have other thoughts?
Well, what constitutes as compliment worthy? Does a haircut constitute as compliment?
I think so, yeah.
Does a clean shaven beard constitute
a shave? Well, not like a regular shave, like if I had a beard and then I trimmed the beard.
Or shaved it off. Does that constitute a compliment?
Maybe.
Does a hair color change? Like if you go from a brunette to a blonde.
Sure, I can see the hair.
Okay, so I'm just changing my skin color to pale white Irish woman to bronze goddess.
Right.
So I
bronze goddess you were. So you think you would feel better about a compliment on a spray tan?
I think it is mandatory to compliment people who get spray tans.
Mandatory.
It's mandatory.
Do you compliment? But even if it's just a regular tan, I guess you do. You compliment someone.
Yeah,
so I never compliment.
I grew up in Chicago. We only had the sun like 3 months out of the year. So when we did have the sun, it was baby oil. It was tinfoil, bounce back. We used to go like on trips to Florida or wherever and come back. And we used to compare our forearms and see how much color we got. And the darker you were, the better.
Right.
Like you wanted to be as tan as possible. And I think probably because I grew up in a super Irish, all of us were pale as ghosts. And so to actually have vitamin D and a bronze goddess look was a compliment.
Worthy.
And obviously as the years have gone by, we realized that it's probably not that good for your skin to fry your skin. So I found an amazing spray tan woman in our neighborhood. I go to her house. She's got kids, goes to school. She's got the sweetest gig in the world. She spray tans in 15-minute increments.
Right.
All these moms and women come in through. I mean, you'd think there was like a drug deal going on. And she does such a good job. And I feel so much better. I feel like I can wear shorts and skirts like I never can with my pale legs.
So when it's all said and done, though, it's a fake tan. So does one compliment a fake mustache if I put a fake mustache on?
A spray tan is equivalent to a hair color change because that's fake. What if you get boobs? What if you get like butt implants?
No,
what if you
I'm
get
not.
What or popular for men? What if you get calf implants?
Is
Are you going to want a compliment?
Is that popular?
That's fake.
I don't know. Do you compliment
that's all
that?
Fake.
If someone gets a fake leg implant.
It's all
implant.
Fake. Everything's fake.
Yeah.
It's all fake. Compliment them.
I don't know if you compliment fake stuff.
I come from a place of mind, peace of mind,
right,
that believes the world is lacking in the compliment department. So give all the compliments.
So I think it's a good optional. If you want to compliment fake stuff, go ahead and compliment fake stuff. But someone shouldn't have to compliment fake stuff. If you look just as good without a spray tan than with a spray tan. So I don't think you need a spray tan before going to an event.
No, here's what bothered me.
I would compliment how you look either way.
I assumed you didn't notice. And then when I found out you noticed, but you didn't compliment and acknowledge my bronze goddess look.
Exactly. It's something that you notice, maybe.
You don't always notice things, honey.
I don't always. All right. Well, so spray tan is pretty, so that's one thing. But we're gonna play a little recording now. This is my friend Andrew from high school, by the way. I haven't talked to him in a long time. And his wife, Nicole. And he's thinking of making a rather major change. He's stepping up from the spray tan, Luce. Listen to this.
Hi, this is Andrew and Nicole. We've been married for 17 years. And if you gave me the opportunity right now, today, to replace my arm with a robotic cybernetic arm.
Wait, your perfectly normal functioning human arm.
Yes.
Okay.
The arms that I have attached to my body right now that are not diseased or broken or hurting in any way, I would replace it 100% with a cybernetic arm. What do you think about that?
I think that that is insane. Why would you change? I think the problem is the timing, because why would you change a perfectly normal functioning arm for a bionic arm? You don't need it. It's just stupid.
That's a little harsh, but it's fair. I would do it because, I mean, just today, I woke up and my arm, shoulder hurt. I don't know. Slept on it funny. It's just there's
pain No. Wait, you said a perfectly functioning human. Yes. No, I'm not. I'm saying, okay, if it's broken or something's wrong with it and you want to change it, fine. But you're saying you would change it right now, even while it's perfectly working.
Yep. I only brought that up as an example of
that's different. The frailty that's different than what
of
you're saying.
Humanity. All of us are going to break down eventually, and I would replace it now. And be ahead of the game.
Preemptively.
Yes, preemptively, 100%. I don't need to go through that. Why would I wait until the tire is flat and I'm on the side of the highway? Why not just get the new tire now and then keep driving? So when I need to hang the 800th picture on the walls, I can do it without complaint. Instead of, my arm, and then going to a doctor and shoulder surgery and then putting it up. You know.
You're a crazy person.
Yep. Well, it's fair enough.
So that's Andrew and Nicole. We'll call them up in a minute. Now, I didn't realize that this was a thing, that people are starting to get the bionic arms.
I've never heard of it.
I looked it up.
Is it a thing?
I mean, people, there are good bionic arms out there now. It's so funny to me. So many questions for him.
Right.
You know, what is the price for something like this? I would imagine it would be probably equivalent to, like, one of your kids' college educations getting a bionic arm. Also, what are the... What can you do with it that is that much better?
Right.
And not having a bionic arm, it's very interesting. And,
yeah,
and probably somewhat selfish, too, to want a bionic arm.
So would you compliment a bionic arm?
And I want to know that.
That would be fake. So
well, I would.
Would you not compliment your high school buddy's bionic arm?
I don't think I would compliment his bionic arm. I would ask questions about it, but I don't know. But I guess if he needed a bionic arm...
Right,
and then
he'd
been wanting one,
very
and then
different.
He got one. Then, so if you needed a spray tan and you got one,
I did need one.
Then I'd be Mr. Compliment.
Have
you know
you
me.
Seen my ghostly arms?
It is they're
transparent.
We both have very pale skin.
Yes,
but this is interesting. Should I call them?
Yes.
Now. All right, we're going to call up Andrew and Nicole right now. What's up, man?
How are you? Not much. How are you doing?
Doing great. Got Lucy, my wife, here too. Andrew and Nicole.
Hi, Andrew. Hi, Nicole.
Hi.
Hi.
It is
so many.
So nice to talk to you, first of all. But this is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard, and we have a lot of questions that we need. You've changed so much, Andrew, since we've last chatted, and you're about to change more, which is exciting.
Now, were you guys in? Was he also a trumpet sectional leader?
He was a tuba player, amongst other things. Andrew, I try to tell Lucy that, you know, we chose to be in that. We all could have been athletes, but in our high school, the band was as cool, and that's what we felt.
Oh, now it's as cool. Before it was
cooler
than
the
football
People
team.
Wanted to be in the band.
Yeah.
I think it was cool. It was definitely cooler.
Yes.
Yes.
It's convenient that I've only met Tom's high school friends that were in band with him to hear that perspective. But I trust you. And maybe that tin from the tuba
has
kind of transitioned into that need to be have tin permanently on your hand. I don't... Maybe?
Please tell.
Stretch. Okay, first of all, act as if someone's never heard of a bionic arm. AKA me, like, explain what these things are, because I have no idea anything about it.
Well, I think the best description I can give, and probably the most accurate one that I'm picturing in my mind, would be Luke Skywalker's hand after he loses it horribly in Empire Strikes Back. He gets the brand new one in Return of the Jedi. It looks just like a normal hand. Everybody's like, hey, normal hand, and it's fine. That's what I'm talking about.
And this reference doesn't help, because we don't watch...
I'm oddly enough.
That.
Yeah, I'm not a, and you may remember this, but I'm not a Star Wars guy. I still haven't seen. I haven't seen the movies.
So. All right. Well, this conversation is over.
But I'm very intrigued by a human getting a bionic arm. But I want to hear, Nicole. Do you have any thoughts on Andrew's arms in general?
They are lovely arms. I don't know why he wants to get rid of them so much. I see nothing wrong with them, or I don't know. I don't know.
Hairy
what
arms, extra hairy, yeah, maybe.
They're not super hairy. They're medium hairy.
That's okay. Yeah, that's acceptable.
muscular.
They're not Popeye arms. Like, they don't have the giant...
You got muscular, masculine, hairy forearms, perfectly capable.
Perfectly capable arms, correct.
Yes. Wow. Okay, so tell me the functions of a bionic arm. What do you get to do that's different than a non-bionic arm?
Okay, well, without getting too crazy, I mean, imagine being able to use your arms as normal, but not get tired, to not feel pain, and to, you know, be super strong, which would be amazing. Come on. How cool would it be to be super strong suddenly?
This is true. Now, does it make your overall body strength stronger by having the bionic arm?
No, it doesn't. And that's an interesting conversation.
No, we're not.
I would love to go down that rabbit hole.
We're not going down that road.
Bionic body, are we talking? Is this the next step?
Oh, God.
Is it going to be like tattoos? Once you get one, you got to get like a bionic leg.
That's the big problem here.
I think that's the thing that Nicole...
But pretty slow.
Yeah.
And what's the price tag on a bionic arm? Because I'm thinking, I know you guys have a couple kids at least. Is this going to interfere with the college plans, et cetera?
And we didn't discuss that.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, as a parent of three kids, it would have to be free.
Free bionic arm.
Right.
And would the bionic arm have the skin touch sensor on the phone when you, like, dial and text, right?
Oh,
the BlackBerry's out.
Yeah, well, if you get a bionic arm that does all the things that I think it would do, you could basically build in all the functionality of a phone into the arm.
Wow.
You just raise up and
like a computer.
Exactly, exactly.
Oh, I'm feeling this bionic arm.
So when we started this episode, we were talking about... So Lucy came home with a spray tan the other day, and I noted and recognized that it was a spray tan, but I didn't compliment that spray tan. So then we got into a conversation that you should compliment someone's spray tan when you see a spray tan. But to me, a spray tan is a fake tan, so it doesn't seem compliment worthy. It seems like you note it, you move on, you look at it, you see it, you move on. I guess I would love your feedback on that, and then Nicole will throw to you. But also at the same time, once you get said bionic arm, is that something where you're like looking for compliments, or is it, do you try to hide it and just be stronger and better?
Oh yeah, I think hide it, but obviously do cool things in front of people. I mean, you know, accidentally tear a door off the
table. So he wants people to say stuff, but he doesn't want to call attention to it on purpose.
Modest.
Trying to be subtle here.
Modest.
Yeah, very superhero of you. Yes.
I do love the spray tan is kind of a not earned tan, so it's not worth complimenting.
Listen here. But he's saying that even the sun-kissed tans are not a trait to be complimented on.
What?
And he said, because it's fake. I said, wait a minute. So if somebody dyes their hair from blonde to brunette or vice versa, do you compliment it? And he said yes, and I'm like, but that's fake.
But that's fake.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. So.
I think it should be complimented, I think.
Absolutely. Well, thank you. Thank you, Nicole. I agree.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. If it generates a feeling of, I appreciate that, you would compliment it.
Maybe he's saying, like, some people don't want to be, like, they want to get their spray tan and not be noticed for it. Like, I'm trying to get a subtle spray tan so nobody notices that I got spray tan.
Oh, no. I'm showing him the tan line. I'm like, look, babe, look at
that. Oh, yeah. No.
I'm like, all my blotchy, white, pale skin is all evened out, and I look like a bronze goddess, and I feel like a bronze goddess, and I go home to a man who... doesn't make me feel like a bronze
goddess. I note it.
Note it and move on. Okay.
I notice what's happening.
Noted.
But you would look good if we went out with it or without it. So I think I'm complimenting your natural beauty.
That's the easy way out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When you note it, did you have some sort of diary or journal?
Thank you. With his bionic journal, he noted.
Well, I do have a journal. I didn't write about that in there. And not to minimize the tan, but it just wasn't journal worthy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But it looked fine. But I say noted more as think of yourself in a workplace and, you know, someone gives you a document and you noted. I received that. Like, noted. Yep. There's a spray tan there.
Right.
I don't want to sound negative here, but if you start equating your wife's spray tan to getting a memo at work.
Thank you. Thank you, Andrew.
That's fair.
I think we have resolved this, and the moral of the story is you compliment your wife if she gets a spray tan.
Right.
And feels like a bronze goddess. Yeah. You are only going to benefit if I continue to feel like a bronze goddess.
Right.
If you take the goddess out of my bronze, like, there's nothing there. It's just sadness.
Yeah. If you change anything about yourself, that he should compliment you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Mm-hmm. Like, even if you get, like, a botched haircut and you immediately regret it, if I go home and I'm like, oh, my God, I do not like this. This does not look good. If you agree with me, that's going to be problematic, right? Like, you've got to be like, no, babe, it looks amazing. It's like the Shania Twain song, Any Man of Mine. Like, you know, even when I burn the dinner, you still, like, compliment it. I don't know.
Right.
Just follow Shania Twain. She's got all the answers.
So the way the show works, like, we're gonna put a vote out whether Andrew should get the bionic arm or not, and then you guys will follow what the audience says, and the price of the arm doesn't matter. Once they vote, that's the decision, and that's what you guys are going to accept and move forward with. So I just wanted to give you a heads up on that. So I would start planning ahead with both scenarios and doing the groundwork
this is
to
not,
have the arm standing by.
That is a little unfair, because if you put that poll up on Life of Dad, he's going to get like 99% bionic arm, because it's all dads voting.
Right.
They're all going to be in favor of the bionic arm. But you know, if you that's, I don't know. We need to do popular vote versus what's the other vote called?
We want to set up a system like they have for the presidential race, where we have the...
Right, the popular vote versus the, what's it called? Oh my God, I can't remember.
I forget as well.
I know
where you're going with it.
Anyways, that doesn't work when I can't remember the punchline to it, but all right. Well, I'm
thrilled that this is even an option, because I've always felt like I was proud when my brother-in-law got a Tesla. So when I have a friend or someone that gets something brand new like this, I think it's amazing. So I hope.
But would you do it?
Yeah, would you do it?
No, I don't necessarily have the need, you know. And I guess it goes back to Star Wars. I've never really been watching something where I thought, you know, that me having that. Oh, I saw the fake hand in The Fugitive. Remember,
like,
the bad guy had a fake arm or maybe a fake leg in The Fugitive.
That was a terrible fake arm.
Yeah, that was.
I know,
not...
and that's why I don't want a fake arm.
No, but like Spider-Man, he had like a cool little like zapper. He could get anywhere with that. I mean, I could see that.
I would take a zapper, yeah.
Yeah, or whatever it's called, a web maker.
Yeah.
Anyways.
I'd take one of those.
Yeah. Cool.
Well, we definitely walked into this show believing that whatever the decision was 100% biased.
That is not true at all.
Nicole, I got you. I'm going to make sure this voting system is not rigged. And we have both wife and husband voice accounted for.
So I don't think we've had, unless I've missed the notices, a high school reunion yet. But I think hopefully we'll have a 25-year one. And then I'll put some, you know, you'll have it by then, right? So then I'll put some, you know, some tests in place and some different, you know, random things for you to pick up and show off. So subtly, you'll be the man of the reunion.
Finally. That's why I've been avoiding it. But if that's in place, I will definitely go then.
Absolutely. The bionic
Encino Man? Are you thinking of him?
No, I'm just trying to find some like fun play on words, but it's gone. My brain said, Mom brain, never mind. retract.
Well, awesome, guys. We will keep you posted. Andrew, now that I've got your cell, I'm going to call you sometime soon to talk about other things. But it was awesome chatting. And Nicole, lovely, lovely meeting you. And my best to both you guys in your arms.
Thank you, Nicole. Thank you, Andrew.
Thanks, Lucy. And call me anytime, Tom. We won't talk about Star Wars.
Sounds great. We'll talk about the Patriots, right? Let's do that.
Perfect.
Yes.
Perfect.
All right, awesome. Have a great night, guys. Thanks again.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
So there it is. The legend of my high school continues, Luce.
I'm confused. Like, if I got a bionic arm, I'd the whole purpose would be to show it off.
Right.
But he wants to get it, but then not tell people he has it?
He wants to do things, do cool things, but...
Why do you keep cupping your body like you're holding yourself?
Oh, I'm
yourself.
Thinking of arms. I'm thinking of, like, yeah, bionic like arms. I guess I'm just checking on my arms now.
To make sure
still,
you have
still
arms?
Still pretty good, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we're going to put the vote out there on our Instagram page, and that's how you guys vote. It's Mom versus Dad Show on Instagram. We would love your feedback on the spray tans. We'll put that vote up, too. Should you compliment a spray tan?
Well, why don't we put up a picture of me pre-spray tan and post-spray tan so people can see just how awfully transparently ghostly of an Irish woman I am versus bronze goddess.
Yeah.
Like a would you rather, and see how many people.
You said bronze goddess a lot of times on this episode.
I feel like a bronze goddess when I get a spray tan. I feel really good about myself. I feel like I glow like Jennifer Lopez. And that's such a hypocritical thing to say that you love me both ways, because you sit in the front row of the Ellen DeGeneres show. You see the most beautiful women in the world come through that show, and all of them are spray tanned. Or all of them who have a light complexion, maybe Caucasian. But J-Lo gets spray tanned? Are you kidding me?
Okay.
That's
I'm not complimenting or talking about a spray tan.
But you said, when you said, who's the most beautiful person in person? You said J-Lo. She glows. Oh.
Oh.
Why do you think she glows? Why do you think she glows?
Your hair looks great today,
Hairspray.
Babe.
Oh,
your hair looks great.
I'm a hot mess right now.
It looks great. Well, thank you guys so much for listening, and we will see you next time here on the Mom versus Dad Show.